Roland Hayes Concert Hall at the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga. We ask at this time that you please silence all cellular phones, pagers, and other digital devices. And also, for the safety of those performing, please refrain from the use of flash photography. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy the performance.
Tremendous guy, and he wrote this piece, Shenandoah, which I really wanted to do with this group because it was commissioned by one of the middle schools that fed the high school at which I taught in Austin, Texas. So I taught at Westlake High School. This was written for Hill Country Middle School with Cheryl Floyd as the director. And Cheryl Floyd was my colleague for 6 years and a very good friend. And I thought it'd be nice to bring this with me to Chattanooga and do this on the first honor band concert with all of you. And the great thing about this, and I'll talk about this a little bit more after this piece, is that they started this last night. So less than 24 hours, this music has been in their hands at this point. And I just think that's really, really cool. So this is a completely different change of pace. So if you were looking for a nice calm afternoon, this one's more your cup of tea. And I hope you enjoy Frank Capelli's Chattanooga.
Thank you.
So the next piece and the final piece that we're going to do is a bit longer, about 11, 12-minute work with this. The thing about Honor Bands, if you've never had a student that participates with an Honor Band, or if you've never seen what happens behind the scenes when you've sent your child to an Honor Band before, is that we showed up on Thursday night, and I didn't really get to meet them all that much, except at registration, I got to say hi a little bit. And then they went and auditioned for our professors at the university here, who, you know, listened to them play some scales, and they did some sight reading, and then they put them in a ranking order, and we assigned them parts based on that. And so then Friday morning, at 8 a.m., we sort of met each other for the first time. And I had no idea about them or how they played. I had a list of music that I thought, well, this might be cool, that might be a little tough, I think that's going to be too easy. You know, and so I've got all these pieces going through my mind, everything that's sort of ready to go. And then we had one rehearsal before sectionals for me to figure out, okay, what's this group about? And what can they do well? What are some things that are going to challenge them? Because I certainly want that. You know, you don't want to come and play music that you can sight read perfectly, you know, but it has to be close, right? And so we spent the first 2 hours on Friday doing that. Then they went to sectionals with our professors again. So they got lots of hands-on experience with our professors here. Or one, if our professors are in the audience, would you please stand and let's give them a round of applause for the work that they've done. Some woodshedding on their individual parts so that we don't have to take ensemble time to do that. And so what I want to tell you before we do this piece is that, A, I think it's beautiful the fact that I've never met them before, they've never met me, we come into the same room, and immediately we can create a product together in that first rehearsal, not just what you're about to hear, which is the finished part. And I just think that that's absolutely incredible. If you've ever had any doubt, you know, I read these articles about we're raising a generation of children that don't know how to connect with other people. If you've chosen to put your child in music, you bypass that. Because they're not on their tablets all the time. Maybe they are, more than you're liking. But they can come here for a weekend and connect with me and connect with one another. They're not all from the same school. And that human connection that they say is being lost, it's not lost with these musicians and with this group. And that is the biggest reason, if anything, to continue to support music education in our schools and in our communities, because this would not happen without it. And so I think now the other thing I'm going to say is that we spent most of the day on Friday rehearsing a piece that you're never going to hear. And that's one of the things that you do with these honor bands. I threw a bunch of music in front of them to see what I thought would be good. I wanted one big piece for the concert, and so the whole won. But we spent a good bit of time rehearsing Chester by Schumann, which is an awesome piece as well, really, really difficult. So is the Holz. And I just thought the Holz would be a better experience for us. And so I just want you to keep that in mind. What you've already heard of the Shostakovich and the Tekeli, and now what you're about to hear from the Holz, this isn't all the music that they rehearsed over the weekend. Because there was an entire other piece that we did a reading of that just didn't make the cut. And that's okay, that's how these honor bands go all the time. You just sort of test the waters and you see what works best for you. Not only that, but they had master classes as well with our professors here. So they spent about an hour and 45 minutes not doing anything with this music, but just learning about their instruments, mechanics of it, perhaps some technique things, and things of that sort, to just sort of broaden their horizons, something that they can take back to their program and go, hey, look, this professor, you can show me. I didn't even know you could finger the note that way. You know, and suddenly, you know, hopefully they're going home with at least one little piece of something that makes them a better musician and a better player in their instrument. So again, I want to thank you so much for sharing your students with us over the past 2 days, and I hope to see many of you at UTC in the future, and I hope to see those of you who are not graduating back here next year so we can do it all over. All right. Cool. So I hope you enjoy the whole first suite.
Thank you.